My name's Nicholas Barnett. I do irrigation is my forte, landscaping and irrigation, but my specialty is the sprinklers, the irrigation sides. Drip line, sprinklers, hydrospirals now is part of my repertoire. You know, I see this hydrospiral as a part of a drip line system. That's where I would classify this, right? I see it as an emitter, you know, just like one of the button emitters, or maybe not quite, but a part of the emitter. So I see it as an essential part to a drip line. And to be honest with you, I see it as the best part of the drip line system. This is the best emitter on the market. That's what I think. You know, that's how I'm seeing it right now. You know, and combined with the Bowsmith, I mean, we got some major technology. Those Bowsmith emitters are hip. And I was against them too. Both these things, I was kind of like, no, new change, you know. I'm a big, you know, now I love them. I mean, how cool is that?
Yeah.
Like, how cool
is
that?
No one knows what that is. It's like, what
right?
is that?
No one knows what that is. Exactly.
Okay, so, what about it? Looks like one of those Rainbird ones that they put on the trees.
First of all, those are the RZWs. Yeah. The RZWs that Rainbird has.
Have you used those?
Hunter has them too.
Yeah.
That's where I started in shoot. I feel like I brought those to Miriam's attention before she even found these, because I do love them. I think they're great. I think those particular Rainbird ones have weak points, have more weak points than these, you know, because they have the swivel attachments on them, mm-hmm. Which have like that little, I don't know if it's a rubber or foam connection, but those pop off of sprinkler systems all the time. So, that's how I look at this system, is how many weak points are there. And so this system right here has a 3-inch weak point, and that's that micro tube. That's pretty much it. Like, that can get damaged and we'll have a small issue, but not a big deal. Those root zone ones can have, so I like them too. You know, those are great. You know, they're awesome.
Yeah. Are you worried about the roots wrapping all the way around the tubes?
I'm not really. Just because I just think it's dispersing so much that I think when roots really have problems, once again, I'm the guy who's digging them up and replacing these roots mm-hmm. issues. It's when there is a fitting, there's like a joint, a coupler, and there's a tiny little crack. That's when there's like just enough room for a root to get in there. That's when it causes problems. Like if there's a lot of water, like, for example, if you have a bubbler, you know, have you ever seen that get clogged with roots? No, because there's like so much water, it doesn't need to go up in there, crawl up in there. So this is emitting so much water in a radius. Why would the root need to go up and around? Because these aren't releasing. If this was releasing a tiny bit of water, then yes, the roots would want to wrap around. But it's getting plenty of water when this runs.
Like, yeah. We don't think so either.
I'm not at all worried about that. These ones will get filled. These ones will get filled a lot.
Did you guys make this yourselves? Or?
So these were old ones from a system put in, you know, 10, 15 years ago.
They're just drilled.
These were, look at, this is the original
hydrospiral. Do-it-yourself one.
See, there's the emitter in there.
So these can fill with sand easily.
Totally. But also the thing is, when you'll see these, that image that we get of something completely getting filled with roots is not typically in a system like this. Like, look, it has no roots on it, right? So not a problem.
Yeah.
It's when these are used as like a drainage system. So commonly this is an issue I run into, is you have a house where your kitchen sink drains out into the yard, typically is running through something like this. Okay, so that's a situation where there's a little bit of water traveling on just the bottom. That's how these things work,
uh-huh.
right? French drainage tube. Just a little bit of water. That, a tree will go in there and try to find where that water is coming from. But if this is flowing a ton of water out there, that's where the roots are gonna go, way out there.
Right. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, I'm not worried about that problem at all. I'm really not. You know, things that we're aware of a lot and something I see a lot is, you know, we plant a Palo Verde tree.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll come back 6 months later, and during a windy season, the tree has fallen over. Okay?
Yeah.
It's a big thing. And then you look and you're like, ah, coincidentally, it had a bubbler on it. So it's only watering on the top. Very hard for it to seep down. The only way you can get it to seep down, well, a common way, is people will put the tree in the center of a hole, right? So then all the water is pooling there in the trunk, which is causes a lot of
rot
and mm-hmm. different problems like that, right? Anaerobic conditions. The roots don't have any reason to go deep.
Mm-hmm.
They're actually growing up.
Shallow, yep.
Very shallow. Roots. So the tree will fall over. So that mm-hmm. is a huge difference too when we are encouraging. We've been on that deep watering kick for everything in the desert. I mean, that's something we've just learned, you know, is the way, you know, and people are so surprised. How should I water this tree? And I say, you're never going to believe me. And then I ask them, how long are you watering the tree? And they're like, you know, I probably do it. You know, I go out there with a hose. And I'm like, dude, I am leaving the hose trickling on it. And then I go to sleep and wake up in the morning. But that's how I water everything now.
Right.
You know, even my little garden, my herb garden, I'm deep soaking, I'm deep watering.
That's what they want.
For short periods of time, too. Mm-hmm. I think even especially in the desert.
Yeah.
Because that's how it kind of operates here, you know?
Yeah. And then let them dry out a little bit and then a deep drink again.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's been really helpful with the spirals. With the gravel in there, a little camouflage. I'm loving them.
Thank you.
You're welcome.